We've got some things to keep you active and involved this afternoon and to keep your minds on. I hope you've enjoyed your day, which of course started last night. You get to see the major themes as you go through the breakout sessions and see the theme of heroes played out around everything from school safety to alternate pathways for students to student voice. And as we heard last night from Chloe, and as you heard the students work today in sessions, that's a key part of what we're doing here, is around the student voice. And that's also what we're going to be doing in this time together. You know, as we talk about the everyday heroes, you know, the people who create those places of heroism are our staff. And the stories they create are powerful. They're magical. I mean, you know, when I hear the story at lunchtime, Amber, you know there's also been schools that are involved, staff involved in supporting her and helping and nurturing her as well. That power is important. And what we forget is how long it lasts, the impact of those heroes on students every single day.
Your chest, you could beat the world, you could beat the war, you could talk to God, go banging on his door, you can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock, yeah. You can move a mountain, you can break rocks, you could be a master, don't wait for luck, dedicate yourself and you go find yourself,
standing in the hall of fame,
yeah,
and the world's gonna know your name,
yeah,
cause you're burning.
You can run the mile. You can walk straight through hell with a smile. You could be the hero. You could get the gold. Breaking all the records they thought never could be broke.
Yeah, do it for your people. Do it for your pride. Are you ever gonna know if you never even try?
Do it for your country. Do it for your name. Cause there's gonna be a day when you're
standing in the hall of fame.
Yeah.
And the world's gonna know your name.
Chain car banging on your chest. You can be a champion.
Part of the message of that video, the Analyst Hall of Fame, is that we have so many heroes, there's no room in one building for them. That's true of all of our systems and all of our structures and all the work we do. And part of what I want us to remember is that the other message of that story is the power of our staff on our students and with our students, and with being the most important word. And that's really the next part of what we're going to do in our time this afternoon, is focus on that voice of students and actually listening to what they have to say, learning from it and thinking how it moves us forward. So Tyler is going to take us from there, and then we have some very, well-informed, well-prepared students, sorry, too much, who are going to take us from that point on.
Thanks, Brian. Is this on? All right. So I've had the absolute privilege today of working with an incredible group of students. We've been in a breakout room having a real discussion about student voice and exploring, you know, where does that responsibility sit, how might we engage in that, and how do we create change? And I think in the spirit of student voice, I'm going to drift away from this microphone as quickly as possible and ask three of our students to come up to just let you know a little bit about what they've been exploring today. So I'll ask up Kent and Zach and Emma to share our learning from today.
So we just want to thank everyone for listening to our voices today and allowing us to be partners in our education.
To start things off, we all value education and learn from each other on a daily basis, whether it's student to teacher, teacher to admin, whatever role we have, we're all learning from each other on a daily basis. Our education not only shapes our current situation, but also paves the way for my future and the future of our community. It benefits us all.
We share a lot of common ground, and it's worth going over that before we start talking about what can change. We want to remember that we're all here for students, and that we're all unified in our goal of providing the best education we can, because we're all partners in our education for the future of our communities.
And I'm just gonna talk a little bit about engaged classrooms. So engaged classrooms give both students and teachers a sense of community and belonging. They also allow the environment to be fun and interactive while still teaching the necessary knowledge and skills.
Our education prepares us for the future, and together we need to work together. Together we need to work to provide the best education that we can for us, our future students, and our future students after that, so that they can be prepared for the next 60 years of their life or even more. And it gives us the skills, not only within school, but after school, to allow us to provide for ourselves and our families for the future.
We want to thank everyone again for allowing us to attend this conference and listening to our voices today. Thank you.
Thanks, guys. So just to give a quick background, so Zach and Kent are both in grade 10. Emma's in grade 9. And that was a curveball I just threw at them. I mean, they didn't know 20 minutes ago they'd be presenting. But that was their attempt as a group to make sense of what they'd explored today. What we'd gone through a process of really understanding how they'd grounded themselves in values, understanding what their own leadership responsibility was, and then moving through an idea of what's our shared values, what's our shared outcome in this, and then looking at what might change in this incredible opportunity that we have. And so that's how they broke it down. Thanks very much.
So as we, so this morning we talked about the video around the harsh negative feedback. They were kind in their feedback. But students have a strong and important voice. We want to use that voice through an activity in the next little while to talk about the power of three. When this morning I talked about the hierarchy of effective communication, how one-to-one face-to-face is the most significant, most important media way down at the bottom, and that what our staff say about our schools is the most important determinant of school reputation, students would be the same in that list. Now, I've had a number of people ask me where they can find all my slides. They are all on my slide share on LinkedIn. If you don't know how to find that, any of the students could tell you how. But basically, that power we have is what we want to harness. That power starts with understanding what are the great things we share. Because honestly, I have an activity I go through where I say, list the top 10 things about your school district, and people look at me blankly. Like I've asked for some Pythagorean theorem. There's nothing back. We need to focus more strongly on the greatness of our school systems, on the amazing things that happen. And that focus means writing it down, and then being willing and sharing it. And so in my district, we're pretty explicit about that expectation. This is what we've shown to all staff in our system.
What's the secret to attract students to the field board? It's an important question for all of us. What can we do? How can we help our community understand how caring field board staff fulfill our mission? To inspire success, confidence, and hope in each student. Bus ads? Billboards? Skywriting? The answer is closer to home. It's you. Research shows the most powerful influence over school reputation is what is said by staff. We have enormous power over our reputation, but we have to use that power purposefully. How? Well, this fall, we want all staff to take three. That's right. All staff at every school and location. Take 3 minutes to share three great things about your school with three people in our community. Especially those people who don't have students in Peel schools yet. Actively share the Peel Word advantage and our positive reputation grows. It's that easy. That's all we ask. But the result can be massive. If all staff take three, we could reach more than 50,000 people in our community and have a positive impact on school reputation and on student recruitment. This isn't hard and won't take a lot of effort or time or any money. All we want is for you to share the great work you already do to inspire success, confidence, and hope in each student. Need some ideas? Want to share your success? Click on the We Inspire Chiclet on your MySide page. And let's all take three this fall.
So we ran that campaign, the first thing that happened was that our student trustees from our board and Peel came forward and said, so we want students involved. And they thought they want the student voice reflected as well. And so our student trustees actually brought together all of our secondary school councils, who then brought together several hundred students to talk about how they could implement Take Three as students. That came from the student trustees to us. Our job was to listen to that great advice. You know, that power of three is important, as is the involvement of students. So what we're going to do in the next little while, your mission, should you choose to accept it, and you have no choice because you're in the room, and the minister's coming, so you can't leave. So here's what we want you to do. I want you to think about three things at your table, three things to actively share about public education, your school district. Three positive things, just like we asked our staff to do, three things. I want one of those three to specifically involve the voices of your students. I want one of those three great things to connect to that. And then I want you to answer the question, how would you share those three as a board, and how would you do it in terms of connecting with students in your district? And finally, how do we further that important connection, that connection between students and boards? Is that roles, is that structures, is that processes around the power of three? And at each table, or almost each table, there will be students who will be there to aid in that conversation, to help with that conversation. And so what I'd like you to do, and this is it, that's the whole activity, it's not that complicated, let me review it in case you lost track. Three good things about your school district, one that involves the voice of students, how to share it as a board and as students, how to further the role of students. That's it, not too bad, not like a board policy or anything, relatively simple. You know, not a boundary change, very easy. Not like eliminate a French immersion, which, you know, we may have done at one point. Easy things. So I had to think about that and have someone at each table identified in advance to email me at the end of our time at this email address what you've come up with. So indeed, we call this accountability for your work. The students are well aware with what that looks like. We as adults, not so much. So I want you to communicate back to me, one person at each table, that information. That's basically it. That's all you have to do. Anyone have any questions? Pretty basic? We have about 20 minutes. That's lots of time for this activity. If you start to lag, I'll make the students force you to move faster. They're good at that. And so I would ask you to spend that time on those things. I'm going to go back to talk about those power of three great things about your district. All right, away you go. So you have about 2 minutes to finish off. Thank you for your table work. The conversations I heard were powerful. If you ask me, my district, when I arrived, was known as being big, and I said, well, lots of things are big. The Titanic was big. You know, Russia used to be big. Big is not good. So, you know, I think we've worked hard to define who we are, and that's what we'll talk about tomorrow when I talked about brand. But if I had to name my top three things, number one, absolutely, is our set of values that focus on inclusion as an organization. And without question, our progressive curriculum, our focus on improving learning. And third, surprisingly, I would think, for some, is our student-focused board. We have a board that every time a decision comes forward, the first thing they ask is, what's best for students? And part of that is to listen to the student trustees who are part of that board. So I hope what you've had today is a chance to think about the good things. We often complain, I know it's hard to imagine, we complain in public education, but we complain no one talks about the good things. No one shares the good things. No one writes the stories about the good things. In part, we need to do a better job of sharing those good things, of sharing those powerful stories every single day. And I hope this process has given you that ability to do it, and the role of the students has shaped it around how they get to play that role moving forward. I thank you for your time and attention, and I believe we now have a special guest that I'm not introducing, but someone else will.